to invite Sandeep Marwa. We purposefully invite him after the lunch sessions so that he can keep people away. Yeah, Sandeep.
Yeah, sir. Yeah, Mr. Marwa. Yeah.
Yeah, Sandeep sir. Yeah, Mr.
Afternoon.
Afternoon. Well, इतना रहे ख्याल सताने के साथ साथ कि हम भी बदल रहे हैं जमाने के साथ साथ. I think there is no need to be panic. There is no need to get worried. There is no havoc. I think I personally believe that it's a very big transformation which is taking place in this world, and very slowly and gradually the whole world will automatically change to the new norms which my friend has just spoken so well. And I think let me give you a case study of my own case. My research center actually been working on this whole system of online education. And trust me, we never ever thought that we will be on online education so fast and so quickly. I think we are the three most important institution in the whole country, IITs, IMM, and AAFT, which changed their line of system on the second day of lockdown. And on the second day, 16th, we were online because we were in the process of testing the whole system. And we are very lucky because we are basically a media institute and are now a media university. And every student is well versed with the computer. Every student is well versed with the operation of new applications. It has taken us only practically 2 days to guide them what applications they have to download and start working on the classes. All the same timetables, which were we've been actually publishing for the next weeks, have been just posted to them, and teachers, they have been guided immediately to start working and start coming on webinars and on master classes and things like that. And imagine a country which has got 1.2 billion mobile connections, out of which 40%, imagine 48 crore mobile phones are smartphones. So in most of the cases, especially schools which are in cities, I think you should not have any problem. You can definitely cope up, but all this problem is going to come back with the people who are staying in villages because they still don't have much of the connections. That's what is going to matter today. In my case, I'm happy that only half an hour back, I had a master class by Professor Karl Bardosh from a Tisch School of Arts, New York University. And he was talking to the whole students of university, and students were more than happy. Before this session, I was going through the remarks of the students. They've been sending me that they really loved the session of Professor Karl Bardosh. Yesterday, we had Arpita Mehta, a very well-known dress designer, and even first we had Arjun Kapoor, who really took a wonderful class and motivated all of our students. There were more than 3,000 students who were listening to Arjun Kapoor at the same time. And my instant remarks were that, oh my God, this is a session equal to Vigyan Bhavan, because there is hardly an auditorium in India which can cater to more than 2,500 students. And we have never seen this kind of earlier, because when you are in your own institution and when you have a celebrity, probably you have an auditorium, 200, 300, 400 people. You cannot accommodate more than so many students at the same go. And I'm happy that this time we are in a position. So these are the new things which we are exploring our own self, though we are in media for such a long time. Yes, very well said. There's a very slight problem with the teachers who are little aged, and they were also reluctant initially for a day or two to come on these kind of things, because he said we are not comfortable talking, because they need to use their hands and walking into the classrooms and things like that. But then when we have requested them that now this time has come that when you have to actually adjust with the system. Now, one very important thing, teachers, obviously they're educated, they're trained, they know how to use computer, they will be able to adjust with the system. Students are much more smarter than you and me, so they know how to use these apps. They are much faster in their applications. But what I am worried about is the people who are not computer friendly. Now, the days are gone for those people who are not computer friendly, people who are fourth class employees who are not needed today. I mean, like, imagine when your whole setup, your school is closed down, you are operating with your administrative staff and you're actually using your faculty. And students are the end takers of the product. But what about all that staff? Now, there is going to be a loss of jobs. And because I don't think so, I need all those 30 to 40 people today who with their the fourth class employees, they are not required at all today now with the rise of this kind of education system. And well, this is a rare chance that when first it was a decision from first to eighth, who've been promoted till ninth, and then ninth and 11th, two classes. Now, the problem is going to come back to now 10th and 12th board, because they have to come back for a physical education. That's what is needed. Yesterday, I was reading and talking to another person from the Ministry of Education, HRD, and they said, we are not well equipped today to take an examination of so many students who are 10th and 12th. It's a lax. And you'll be surprised to know the figures that I was talking to a few foreigners, and they were actually shocked when I gave the figure. We have 15 lakh schools in this country. We have 700 universities. We have 40,000 professional colleges. And all together, we have around 32 crore students who are, or rather I must say, who actually been affected one way or other way because of this coronavirus or COVID-19. But I think hats off to Government of India, who has taken one very strong step and saved 32 crore students and probably 1 crore the faculty, teacher and administrative staff in school and colleges from this such a dangerous COVID-19. We have to appreciate that also side by side. I think you have to be smart. You have to have a smartphone in your pocket. You have to have a, next is your laptop or a desktop. So you have to be connected. This is going to be the first aim in education department, because this whole thing is going to, even if we are open by another 2 months, let's say, because in any case, the new sessions, they have already been postponed to September, because now you have to start your session in September. But trust me, that is not going to be the end. The fear which everyone has taken over, this is going to take probably another 6 months. Slowly and gradually, this is going to go. And I think all of us in education will be comfortable only by next April, 2021. And that's going to be the real time when things will be normal. And I don't know how much this whole thing is going to take. Nobody knows, rather. But from January, we have to keep in mind the social distancing, which is a very important, is going to be a habit now. And no classroom is going to be 60 or 100 people. This is going to be a very soon Ministry of Education is going to send across the specifications, how you have to conduct classes in schools and colleges. No student is going to be more than 20 to 30 in one classroom. There has to be a distance of 2 chairs in between two students. And all those basic things that you have to be clean. And there's another very important thing which I have suggested, to have a cleaning machines, a machine which is going to spray on you when you are entering into a education, which is not going to be very expensive. But that machine has to be kept at the entrance of the every education center, teachers, students, guests, or even the other staff, administrative staff, lower staff. Everyone has to go through that machine, get yourself cleaned through those unaffected, not very strong chemicals, so that at least to some extent, you are clean when you are entering into the premises. I think a very important thing, I don't know if you have noticed or not, the radio station, yaniki online system, what I'm trying to come back, and television, which has grown 70% in 40 days. If, let's say, for example, if there were 10 crore listeners, now there are 17 crore listeners on radio station Can you imagine the rise in online programs? I mean, as an industry, if I talk about media and entertainment industry, we are suffering a lot because 12,000 theaters, they have closed down, and we are losing almost an audience of 1.5 crore people every day who used to watch cinema. Yes, who used to watch cinema in theaters. We've lost in crores. The estimate loss for 40 days is something like 3,000 crore for media and entertainment industry. So, but I'm happy that people are still cooperating and everyone is ready to bear his part of loss when it comes to filmmaking, film distribution, theaters, and all ancillary things which are associated with the media and entertainment industry, because we somehow also supporting tourism, catering, transport, parkings, and so many things which are being supported by our industry. When a film moves, everything moves, trust me, including malls, they move.
Correct.
Yeah, and coming back to education, I think one very important thing which probably somebody just spoken, but then I go other way around, I think it is teaching a lot to people to be punctual. Because when I'm saying that I have Arjun Kapoor at 11:30, trust me, 11:30, 3,000 connections were on. I can see people. They're there. And it used to be other way around. When you are having a program in your auditorium and when you have informed in different classes that please come down, our guest is here, and we take your seats in the auditorium, then students are taking their own time. They're coming in a very relaxed mood and they're entering and your whole thing is getting delayed, Indian Standard Time, which you call. And but now here I'm thinking that people are becoming more punctual, very particular. They are demanding. And the kind of a messages we have started coming in, they have started taking quite a keen interest that who should be present on the net and who is not. That's also another, they become choosy also. And another very important thing which this whole system has brought to this system is, sir, that those days of talking about all those prasangs are over.
Right.
You're entering into the hall and then you're talking and kind of introductions and delivering of flowers and presentation of this introduction to the topic. Those days are gone. People are very specific. Students, they want these kind of seminars to the point. You are here, one line introduction and cut to the point. Come to the place. And the minute you are delaying on this webinars, and trust me, students, you'll start seeing students going out of the system.
Yes.
Because they're finding it boring and they say it's a waste of time because they have too many things today to do. Exactly. They're all the time on social media. They're all the time on television. They're ready to listen to a lot of news. They're listening to songs of their choice. Now they are sitting back home. There is no teacher who is with Danda. Or his harsh words to correct him, and everything is at leisure. So the most important thing is that your education has to be very smart, quick, to the point, and days are gone for 1.5 hour of classes.
Right, sir.
Everything has to be cut down to 40 minutes, which is the breathing time as per the United Nations UNESCO conclusion, that classes has to be 40 minutes. And so that the grasping power of a student, it falls immediately after 40 minutes. I think these things are going to come back and we are still working for it. And I think we are all learning, I swear. We all are learning today with this new system. And these, what we have, I've just said, they have become now, and I feel they've become norms and they're going to remain for the next few years.
Thank you so much, Marwa Saab. It is always a pleasure hearing you.